ভয় দোহে তত্ত্ব দুর্গেও জানিবা। Here he is explaining about the service of Balaram. Krishna serves Balaram. Now he is explaining about Balaram Shiva. Anurage Krishna Kara Shiva. Balaram is serving Krishna with his deep love. And that time, when he is serving Krishna, he is also maintaining the same respect as Guru. Baladeva Mahasaya Apuni Krishna Seva. He himself is serving Krishna in various way. Here, when they are doing their Sakhalila, then sometimes Krishna will be tired, then Balarama also doing the same seva, like messaging his food. Apuni Krishna Sevayo Dohe Tattu Durgyo Janiva. Sometimes he is messaging the lotus feet of Krishna. Sometimes he is feeding Krishna, because Krishna will forget to take his food. Sometimes should control Krishna. No. Sometimes in the leaders, we can see so many demons were killed by Balarama. Isn't it? When Balarama is there, always Balarama go before Krishna to the demons. No. They'll give you some problems. I'll go there. And sometimes, together, they are fighting with the demons. And they kill the demons. In that way, he is maintaining to protect his brother and serving his guru as Krishna. And he is controlling Krishna for doing his pastimes. If Krishna will play so much with the friends, if he will run so much, he will be tired. Then he cannot play Srimati Radharani and the Sakis. Balarama knows when and where they will meet to each other. Because he is arranging everything with yoga maya, is not? So if Krishna will be so much tired, then he cannot please Srimati Radharani with all the sense. That's why Balarama has to control. Oh no, don't run so much. Now we have to take rest sometimes. No, brother, we should continue our play. No. We'll together take some rest and we can watch their playing. So Krishna has to take rest. And when you will take rest and watching the playing, then Balarama will feed Krishna. Krishna, now, this time for taking food. See? Mother, he made this laddu. She made this kheera very nicely. She can taste it. During watching, Baladeva will feed Krishna. And Krishna is watching this playing of their friends, and at the same time he is taking foods by Balarama. In that way, Balarama also serving Krishna. Same respect like Guru.
Over Tavya,
what?
Over Tavya.
This is Dasya Mood. Serving, when they are serving to each other, that is dasyam. Here, he explaining this.
But when he feeds him, like mother?
No.
Like guru.
Here. Sakya bhave dohe samo, dasye dasyo dohapomo. It's not parental mood, not vatsalya mood. When they are serving their gurus, that means they have vatsalya mood, dasya mood. As a servant. So, they are serving to each other. They are respecting each other. They have very deep attachment for each other. That's why we have to go first to Balarama Mula Sankarsana before Krishna. If we'll get this presence from him, from Mula Sankarsana, then we can realize, and at the same time, we can realize about the truths of Krishna. And if we get blessings of Krishna, then we can realize the truths of Balarama. No one can explain. Only Balarama can explain the truths of Krishna, and Krishna can explain the truths of Balarama. Balarama Tattva, Mula Sankarsana Tattva. Otherwise, no one can explain this. And Balarama, he can explain Anangamanjari, in Anangamanjari Swarup, she can explain the truths of Srimati Radharani, not even Krishna. Until now, Krishna is trying to realize the mood of Srimati Radharani. Nitya Lila. Always it is happening. This Lila is happening always. So, still now Krishna is trying to realize the mood, the depth of his love, of her love, the sweetness of her love. Krishna is trying to realize this, trying to feel this. But if we go to Mula Sankarsana, Ananga Manjari, then she can explain. Only she can explain the truths of Srimati Radharani. She knows everything. Mula Sankarsana knows everything about Krishna Tattva. Only he can explain. In Navadvipa Lila also, if we'll get blessings from Nithananda, then we can realize the truths of Sanat Mahaprabhu. And if we'll get blessings, if we'll get kripa, 100% kripa from Sriman Mahaprabhu, then we can realize Nityananda Tattva. Oti gurho Nityananda ei avatare chaitanya jananjale sijanite pare. Only he can realize the truths of Nityananda. We'll get this knowledge direct from Sriman Mahaprabhu. No one can explain. Oti Gujya, very secret. Oti Gurha, very important. And both are, you can say, it's beyond to our intelligence. Only by bhakti, only by pure love, kevala bhakti, kevala prema, sadhaka can realize these truths. So, before we'll enter our Radhanga Bhajan, we have to fix this point in our heart that they are non-different. Krishna and Balarama. Krishna, Srimati Radharani and Ananga Manjari, they are non-different form. They are in the same place, same mood, same body, but different name. same activities, but in the different form. So, today we have to say this, after this, tomorrow we will start from Brajavilastava. This is also very nice sloka from Brajavilastava. There we'll enter some more deep. Hari Bol.
Hari Bol.
If you have a question, you can ask.
Short word.
Yeah.
We mentioned, as we know, I want to know if exists a mantra or Gayatri for Lord Balaram. Or if not, then maybe we don't need.
There is mantra for Balaram. There is mantra Gayatri for Balaram. But if you chant this Yugal mantra, that means mantra, Yakupal mantra, that is enough for getting the creeper. You can get this same blessings from Rama, from Murasankarsana, from Ananda Manjari.
So it's same, not different.
Not different.
There's no need, but if it exists, we could.
Yes, it is exist because maybe you have love. No need to worship them separately, but if you have strong attachment, deep love, then you can. That's why there is mantra. That is why there is Gayatri.
Prabhu, I would like to ask some days if you can say something about Ramachandra, who was writing Ananda Manjari something.
Yes, Ramachandra Thakur.
Something.
He was adopted son of Janumama, Ramachandra Goswami. And he got this power from Janumama directly. He was the disciple of Janumama. And she empowers him.
Other name is
Ramaitaku. His other name is Ramaitaku, nickname, you can say Ramaitaku. But when he was very little boy, very little boy, in his childhood, Janumama, she found something very surprising qualities in Ramaitaku. So she adopted him. She wanted to take care of this moves and this power. And then she empowered more Ramaitaku to establish this bhakti for everyone. That is why he can explain the truths of Ananda Manjari Tattva about Janumama. Because Janumama, she empowers him directly. Before Ramaitaku, no one explained in that way about Ananda Manjari.
Today's Virachandra Prabhu Supreme Spirit. Virachandra Prabhu Supreme Spirit.
Virachandra Prabhu.
Today is his appearance
day. Yes. Today is Virachandra Prabhu's appearance day.
Yeah.
And we should know some truths about Virachandra Prabhu. When the time came for Sriman Mahaprabhu's disappearance, then all the devotees, they are very sad to know this. Because they realized that Now very soon Prabhu will stop his this external lila. He will close this. That's why they ask, oh Prabhu, how will life without you? Because we have nothing in front of us, our life, our heart, our breathing air, everything is you. You will find this verses in Chaitanya Bhagavat also. Then Mahaprabhu is saying to them, you must know I'll come again in the form of Son of the Calendar. Avraham Thakur was there. He was Sridhama Shakha. He was Sridham in Braj Leela. So he asked Sriman Mahaprabhu, is it true? Yes. I'm promising to everyone, I'll come back again. Because there is something late of my activities. Because of my sannyas, I cannot fulfill all my duties. So I'll come again as son of Nithan. Avraham Thakur, he said, okay, I'll just this. I'll just this truth. Then Nithananda Prabhu, whenever he will get one new baby, Avraham Thakur will come. And when he will offer his pranam to this boy, then he will die.